What's up, everybody? This is Daniel Jones. This is a video called First Impressions. First impressions are important in life and everything. That includes video games. And so, I'm going to do a video about first impressions of various games. And we're starting with Bloodborne. With pre-release marketing touting the game's brutal challenge, and its reputation preceding it, Bloodborne didn't need much help letting players know what it was all about, kicking your ass and beating you up until you could finally overcome whatever challenges it threw at you. To that point, though, the opening hours demonstrated that philosophy beautifully, and gave players, especially newcomers to the Souls series, a hands-on look at what it really means to revel in the series' trademark masochism. Bloodborne's in media res opening drops you into a gothic world of monsters and Lovecraftian nightmares. After the character creation scene, you awaken in a hospital with no weapons, no armor, but you're forced to face off against a corpse-eating werewolf that devours you in seconds. After death, you're resurrected in a celestial, surreal landscape called the Hunter's Dream. It's all very strange. You're given a melee weapon, a firearm, and sent back to the hospital to defeat that same werewolf. The fight is simple, but it's a perfect microcosm of what makes Bloodborne so compelling. Death breeds triumph. It's the first of many times that you'll die in this game, but it's also one of the many times that you'll triumph over what may have previously seemed impossible. From there, you'll step out into a massive, spectacular Victorian landscape of towering cathedral spires and soaking wet cobblestone streets. The setting sun hangs low and large in the background, silhouetting the architecture, including a large bridge that you see as you exit the clinic. As you explore, you'll hear the occasional screech of a beast off in the distance. That's the cleric beast, most likely the first boss that you'll encounter in the game. Immediately, you come across a procession of torch-wielding villagers, and this is where Bloodborne's gameplay really starts to shine. The villagers are marching back and forth from a larger group, standing vigil at a crucified, burning corpse of a werewolf, just like the one you killed in the clinic. You'll quickly learn that it's unwise to take these guys on in a large group. With this scenario, the game teaches you how to utilize the tools at your disposal to isolate enemies, such as the pebbles that distract them and make it much easier to take them on one-on-one. Most players will die at least once in this opening zone the first time they play, as they learn to strategize and manage more deliberate tactics. Bloodborne is constantly communicating with players and teaching them how to survive its foreign nightmarescape. This area where players encounter the angry torch-wielding mob is just one of the many teaching moments in Bloodborne. This first zone of Central Yharnam never stops teaching players about the rules of Bloodborne. On your way up to meet the screeching cleric beast, you'll learn many things about how to play this game. Whether it's discovering the hidden path through the sewers, or how to cheese the werewolves in the doorway on top of the bridge, or the first time you open up a gate to a shortcut, each of these moments is a tiny revelation. Though Bloodborne is constantly teaching you, you'll never feel like it's holding your hands. Like Dark Souls, the game's directions are obtuse at best. For instance, you'll reach that bridge that you saw at the beginning, but your path is most likely going to be blocked by two incredibly tough werewolves. You have options for disposing of them, but head-on combat is ill-advised and shouldn't be your first option. If you explore the bridge before the wolves, you should find a path to the sewers. Following this path will bring you around to the other side of these wolves. The enemies there are tough but manageable. And rather than point a big arrow with a sign that says, "Sewers this way, dummy!" From Software and Bloodborne just puts a near impassable barrier in your way and tasks you with figuring out the rest. You have other options, but you're meant to find the sewers, and it's a helpful way to gain experience on your way to fighting the beast. Eventually, you face off against the cleric beast, and like the werewolf in the clinic, you'll likely die in your first attempt. When you return to the hunter's dream, you meet a new friend and gain the ability to level up, or channel blood echoes, as Bloodborne puts it. Next time you meet the cleric beast, you'll have better knowledge of its strengths and weaknesses, as well as stronger gear and weaponry. What's most exceptional about Bloodborne is the level design. The areas overlap on themselves and interlock with shortcuts and new routes. Nowhere is this better exemplified than in Central Yharnam, the first area in the game. From atop the bridge, you can look down at the courtyard below, where the pitchfork mob stands vigil over the werewolf effigy. Meanwhile, the sewers have multiple entries and exits leading to various different parts of the map. You can even make it to the second boss, Father G, before even fighting the cleric beast, if you so choose. I don't recommend it, that guy's a jerk. This level design creates a sense of progress even when you're not actually making much definitive progress. All the while, Bloodborne's story and lore are introduced to you through NPCs shuttered into their houses during the hunt, or through the many visual clues in the architecture and art design, or through the item descriptions. Other little hints come in the form of haunted cries of your adversaries. But like everything in the Souls games, Bloodborne's story is always left obfuscated and mainly exists in service of the gameplay. The opening hours of Bloodborne are harsh, terrifying, nerve-wracking, and frustrating, but all of it culminates in a consistent sense of progress and accomplishment that few games are able to create. It's a small sliver of a huge game that will continue to test you throughout its dozens of hours, but few moments top the first time you step foot in the blood-soaked streets of Central Yharnam. If you like this video, let me know. Follow me on Twitter at IndieJones84 and subscribe. Until next time, this is Daniel Jones.